Okay, I'm back again. I just a few things to take care of, and now I'm back. Let me see here. I was gonna check my crops. I was gonna check my crops. Visit Alex's crater, which will be nice. I think I got enough time for that now. I may retrieve that spawner. I don't know. Won't take me too terribly much effort. I've got a few things to work with that. Hello? Okay. Now let me see. My dye crops are nice, but I don't think I need that right now. I mean, it's good to accumulate it, though. I wanted to make sure I had everything. Whoa. Oops. Stepped on a mandrake. Well, I can replant that. A lot easier. See, air crop, good, glowstone, nature, ouch, fire, water, magnesio is low, earth, more magnesio is good, yeah, it looks like most of them are pretty good right now. One of the things I got from that dragon loot was, in fact, some more lapis, so that's increasing my, luck on this. It is weird being able to use, pickaxe's, fortune trait. Or in this case, general luck trait, to be able to harvest crops, but that's the way it works with tinkers, is that it allows that to happen. Oops, I double hit. But I did get 2 dye seeds. Nice. Huh, well. Oh, not that again. Why won't you? Sometimes it seems to not work. I don't know why. Sometimes the soil around here doesn't till. But it should be able to till. It's just not always doing it. There we go. Perfect. Gonna waste it off there. I got another one again? Wow, the extra fortune I put on this was nice. I just added just a little bit more lapis, and suddenly it's going really well with it. Maybe I should disable that option. I mean, I could. There's nothing against it. It's just one of those things. I don't know if anybody ever really got why they... Oops. Again, this thing is maybe a little too powerful now, because it's going through it. It didn't used to do that. What? Where'd my... Oh, that again. Just a moment. Yeah, that accepts anything that counts as a tool, including tinkers. So, that's something I need to be wary of. And huh, that regressed on its own. Nice. I'll just jump over here. Wow, I just drifted so far. Just need to remember to tap that a bit better. Ah, there we go. I'm just collecting my various essences before checking on just how well my my fish traps are going along. I think they're gonna go pretty darn well now. Because they have the... Yeah, I may finally... Yeah, I'm starting to... You know, with this armor, it actually doesn't deal much damage, though. Just kind of a jarring sensation. Yeah, like, not even a point of damage. It's just hits. I can see how that would be inconvenient in combat, but... Theoretically, I mean, what if I pushed a mob on there? Would it hurt them? I mean, as long as it hurts mobs and players, then you can use that to farm them. Because you can be very interesting using a magical crops as a mob trap. That would be kind of new. Okay, just the magnesio. No new seeds. Okay, fine. That's okay. The thing is, every time I get a seed from them, though, it does really help out because it saves me a lot of effort because the seeds take 8 magnesio each. So. It's kind of good to conserve power that way. Because I can get a lot more. So I got my little elemental collection going here. Okay, so there's nothing in any of these according to the holographics there. Mm-hmm. Yep, this is working out really well. Can I reach that far down just to the... I'm trying to reach over there, thank you. Huh, that's a slight issue. I have to get to the water first. Well, there's things I can use to get around that. Power... Wow, I'm taking this one right now. I already have a good fishing rod, so I'm clear there. And taking this one, I can combine these two on an anvil. Wow, this is accumulating fast and well. I just need to check these once in a while, and I'll be very, very good. Okay. That's taken care of, so I've checked my traps and stuff. It's kind of a more of a maintenance thing. I'll probably do that more off-camera from now on, but just seeing how well that accumulated on its own. Did I accidentally hit a cotton plant? I think I accidentally hit a cotton plant. Yeah, I'm gonna need to rest a moment because, sundown. Dye seeds. An actual technicolor essence. I'm gonna have to expand this later. That's like a definite. Oh! Quick experiment. Can I repair these with this Mind Fantasy repair kit? Please. Normally works. Maybe it's because it's enchanted. This is the advanced one, so it should work a lot easier. But it's not doing it. I think it doesn't work as well on enchanted stuff. So whenever I combine these on an anvil, I probably have to go greater price. Oh well, I tried making it a little cheaper. Eh, it would have been nice and convenient. Hello, everybody. Yep, suddenly outside again. I think you're all getting used to how this works. Did I not name the pig yet? Named the cow. He's still the random sheep. I think I'm gonna call that a spy chicken. But then there again, there's more than one chicken, so it wouldn't be as good of a joke. I actually don't really need more eggs right now, so just saying. Okay. Never mind. I can head off now. Okay. Here's my progress. I'm gonna put like a cap on that and then differentiate between like various things kind of branching off, but that is literally as high as I could get off the amount that I was able to save from the other world. Or rather, have saved for me. So, it's kind of reached its limit. So, yeah, there's nowhere I can go from there. I'm gonna have to get more materials, and that's one thing I'm really hoping of doing is to get something nice. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have to start on Botania early, or if I'm gonna go to the ether, if I'm gonna use limestone, but I certainly want a light-colored block. I might use limestone. It's actually pretty good. Okay, now let me see. Where do I need to go from here to get to there? Because I kind of am trying to remember this. Okay. Now I remember. I do go this way. No trees? Yeah, now I remember. I'm going through this area. It's kind of been a little while. Oh, was there a zombie? Riding a chicken. Again. Well... seen that before. It was pretty good to just run along the shore, although I have a funny story about that. I was shoveling up some gravel ore along the side, and a minotaur just came along and smacked me into the water. I was able to take him down because he was slowed down by the water himself quite a bit whenever he was trying to chase me down, but it was just more like, hey... What's going up here? So he's like, hi, how are you? Let me knock you into the water thingy. I'm just gonna knock you into the ocean. At least I'm presuming that this is technically the ocean. Otherwise, it'd be a very, very large lake. Pretty sure this is an ocean. What's the F3 say? Yeah, it says, yep, it's bordering the ocean. So that's definitely how that went. But yeah, I had a minotaur just pop out and knock me into the ocean from the beach. I was just grabbing some gravel ore, and then a minotaur decides to relocate me very swiftly. Okay, I think I'm getting pretty close. This is when the speed boost of this armor comes in handy. You can, but yeah, again, this Tinker's Construct gravel ores. They have to be shoveled. They can't be mined with a pickaxe. So they're a bit different. They still count as ores. They still have the right materials when they're processed. It's just that they're a little bit different. So I was pretty sure it was along the shoreline that I got there. Oh yeah, that's looking very familiar. Hey, yeah, we're about there. This is the village next door to it, the obelisk, and I should be able to find the crater somewhere nearby. Where are you, Alex Crater? Because I thought you were very close to the city. Very, very close. Okay. Yep, here's the crater. Yeah, I remember how this happened. Or at least, what the signs say. Okay, I'm gonna have to differentiate here, because, yeah, they had a nice tower built, and it kind of was exploded. But that's okay. It was nice. I'll probably find it again, though they've probably relocated since then. So do I need any of those resources right now? I don't think so. The cows seem to like this place. Oh well. I'll grab the rest of the stuff while I can. I had some I had some of my totemic stuff already ready to go whenever that world had its issue. And, then things happened. In my head, that was a bit tricky to do because, there's this issue with, this exact version of the mod where it seems to not be liking having its recipes looked up in the NEI, so every time I was reminding myself of what they were, there was like at least a 50% chance it would crash. So trying to be the shaman of the server wasn't exactly easy. So yeah, I had a slow, grueling moment, but luckily that stuff was saved, and water garden. Yoink. Yep, you can always click Pam's Gardens and just collect them. Well, you know, use click, don't attack click, because if you attack click, you break them, and then you will get their stuff right then. But if you want to, like, stockpile them to get their stuff later, you can just use click instead. So right click, not left click, and then you're fine. Do I want to... I might want a little berry. Thank you, Mind Fantasy. I appreciate the berries. I was a little confused by some of your earlier stuff because I'm not as used to Mind Fantasy as I am some other things, so stuff happens. Okay, I was looking down here. Oh, we have wolves. Do I have bones? No, I do not have bones. I need to remember to have bones when I come in this direction because I keep seeing these wolves and I keep forgetting to take some bones. So I'd like to just tame some normal wolves. The one from Useful Pets may be nice, but is, for some odd reason I can't look into his menu without crashing. So, yeah, I can't actually use them like that. But hey, working on it. A lot of the other things are working perfectly fine. There's just a few little slips here and there. But otherwise, nice. Just a little hunger saturation there. Okay, hi sheeps. You're nice sheeps. I need to come here with that book whenever I'm ready to choose my class. I'm getting closer, but I'm gonna have to assemble something decently large. I heard that. Did you really just manifest right behind me? Oh yeah. He manifested right behind me. I'm not in the mood right now. Why is this thing withered, but I'm not actually taking damage? Okay, that's a little weird. I didn't think my armor was that good. Usually you require heavy protection before that factors in. Hmm. Well, that's new. Yeah, I was hit by an, I was just hit by an Eldritch Guardian. I don't, the Wardens are the big bosses, so that's much later on. I was just hit by an Eldritch Guardian. So, yeah, their blasts are supposed to wither you for a bit, and I'm not taking the actual damage, so I don't think that's a desync issue. I think that is literally, like, either my armor is that darn good, or something else just makes a wither less dangerous. I mean, it does have auto-repair and stuff on it, but I don't think it automatically has wither resistance on it, too. Although I could be off on that. Because it's one of those things that I'm just not sure. I mean, there could be something else in the mod pack that's making it that good. I mean, it doesn't have a direct level like the level up system per. I mean, it has the armor XP level from Ars Magica 2, but it doesn't have like a level up system from the levels mod like the weapons do. So I don't think that it can just pop up and have a trait that says wither resistance. I mean, that would be kind of cool, but it'd be very cool, but at the same time, I just don't think you can do it. So why is it that I was withered by that guy and totally did not get fazed by it at all? And I need to come here with a better shovel at some point and get this too while I'm at it. Because it's nice, it's an aluminum, so that works. Oh, by the way, if you hear someone say aluminium, that's also correct because it's like a regional thing. Like, it's mostly like a European thing to say it that way, while aluminum is like the usual way in a lot of other parts of the world. So it may vary a bit by region as to how they say that. But yeah, I picked up my stuff. But yeah, I can't look at the recipes because of issues. Now, some other things I used to have in that world previously that they managed to save was my Ring of Fire for getting a Vist discount with Thaumcraft later, but that won't factor in for a while. A copper chest that I used to have. Now, this one is from weapon case loot. It's actually pretty darn good, and I'm wondering if it stacks with my special armor, because it gives you haste, strength, and resistance. So that will be awesome. I could just equip this for now, because otherwise I'd have to put it in another slot or something. I'm definitely running out of slots. Okay. Little milk, please. Thank you. If only I could find myself some cocoa beans, then I would be able to, well, I'd be able to have chocolate milk. I do know a way to get a hold of them after a while. It'll just take a little magic. You can transmute something into them eventually, and I am ready to do that, kind of. I have what I need to transmute, I just don't have the means. But I'll get my way up to it. I always regain my abilities from one world to another eventually. It just may take a little time. And I am having some serious extra eggs going around. Eventually this area will be loaded with chickens, I just know it. Oh well. Well, I do believe I am now properly equipped to set up my shaman abilities. Or did I accidentally leave something behind? Hmm. I could have sworn I had a book somewhere. Did I? Am I missing my book? I'm missing my book. Okay. Somehow, I don't have the right book. Okay, do I have enough paper? Yes, I do. Good. And by the way, if you look at the recipes and that glitch happens, it will... Well, basically, do it even in the book, so I can't even look up the recipes in the book. At least with a guaranteed chance. Again, it didn't always do it, but it was a thing. I haven't had this happen to me in later versions of the mod. Okay, so let's see here. This is kind of a side path. This isn't something that's considered at one point or another in the quest. This is a side path to magic. So as I become a shaman again this way, things will be a lot easier. I already had a lot of things almost ready, but there's a few ceremonies I still needed to do. And I am curious if this one here, the Zafgil Waltz, will be able to help grow magical crops. Flute and drum, okay. So, I'm trying to remember the range on that. I do know that it's enhanced the more music you have pre-charged into your totem, and how tall it is does help, so the amount of music accumulated is very important. Let me see, the rain dance and the drought ceremony are things that I need buffalo to do. And the reason why is simple. I need a rattle. And to make a rattle, I need some buffalo teeth. The thing is that I can actually do everything from memory, pretty much. But the problem is that I can't even get close to looking something up. I can actually craft it, I just can't look at it beforehand, for some reason. So it's like a weird way that it's working. But let me see here. What do I need to do for buffalo? Okay, I need that and the wind chimes. So after I get this set up, I can try capturing some additional cows and prepare to turn them into buffalo. And dude, in that exact position, you look like a statue. I mean, that looks like... You realize you're literally standing yourself on a pedestal to look like a statue. I'm just saying that is what you look like you're doing right now. I think he's fine with that. Yeah, I need to start getting, like, multiple heavier chests to work this, because agriculture in this pack is so expanded that I'm gonna need bigger chests. Luckily, I do have a few expanded chests, including copper. I have plenty of iron, especially because it keeps dropping out of the sky in the form of dragons that wind up giving me valuable loot. So I think I have enough iron to really expand my chest. And of course, I also really need to keep going on my special area up there. And as I expand that, I should probably take more of the magical stuff over there, like the magriculture. I about said magriculture. That actually would have been a cool word. Magical agriculture. Magriculture. Ah, I actually like that. Okay, I'll go with that one. Okay, one thing I've been wondering about is whether or not those would hold. They've held. This weapon rack, I can't look directly at it because of that one thing. But you can see how it actually shows you your weapons in it. That is from Bigamo Chattels, and it's one of the parts of the quest. The loot chest seemed to have had a desync issue and didn't always actually hold this loot, so I had to put that up. It was looking pretty cool at first, but whenever I reloaded the file, I kind of lost a sword. Yeah, that was a problem. It's a good thing I got the rest of my stuff back from another world, but now I have literally, like, nothing else from it. I'm going to have to do everything else from here. I have no remainder left. And I definitely need to continue on my quest and expand my beautiful mage tower I was working on. Again, from a good-sized distance, it doesn't look quite as impressive, but I'll go back up there eventually and show it off, especially whenever I start building on more areas. I might start moving my agriculture there next, because I need to, I kind of need to expand that out, and I also need to have a place to do my, like, I can do shaman magic in multiple locations pretty easily, and I can even make it portable. But, I mean, now that I've got that capability back up again, pretty much, I'm going to have to really, like, start considering, like, adding on as I go when it comes to my magic. Like, expanding out here and there. I don't know which side. I don't know if I'll actually expand off the main area I built for it there, or if I'm going to, like, go off from the island. I mean, it's nice and green on the island. It would be a good transition, but, I'd have to go across the island every time. I'll think about that. Oh well. Okay, never mind. Well, I visited Alex's crater. That was nice. Checked my crops and traps, but that's an ongoing thing. Magical crop tree. Again, that's an ongoing thing whenever it pops up. Adventure, kind of did that a little. Kind of. Let me see here. Otherwise, I think things are going pretty well. I'll probably have to reorganize here and figure out anything else. Oh, as for future quests. I do know in advance that this will take a serious effort. I mean, these are okay, because you can just craft those normally, but these I'm going to have to work on. So, yeah, and I also can't do that here. I may have to go somewhere else. And the reason why is because if you create the special blast furnace from Mine Fantasy 2, it will shoot fire everywhere repetitively whenever it powers up. So I can't allow it to just roast everything. I need to build a dedicated spot that will be very fire retardant. So, yeah. Again, as I was saying, only these can be made. Again, the button is not saying things directly there. So everything else will have to require Mine Fantasy methods to make. And I can look that up pretty quickly here right before I head off. You see, it should be in here, under the forge, I believe. Ah, that reminds me. I need to make some chimneys. Even if mainly for later, I need to make some chimneys. Because getting nauseated by the flames and stuff is definitely something I wouldn't want to do too terribly often. Of course, I don't actually do that action very often in general, so. Let's see, refining. Yellowing. I think this is a basic forging. I don't think it has the full thing right now. Where's those bricks? Because, well, this is under artisanry, so maybe I need another kind of engineering to get that done. I need to go all the way. Huh. Okay, these apparently require some stuff later. Construction. First stone, glass, reinforced planks, clay panel. Thatch, bricks. No. I made some limestone bricks. Again, I think they're thinking that you should just assume that anything related is in the same patterns, because this doesn't say right here that you can do it with limestone, but I know you can because I've done it with limestone. And the same thing also applied for me making that regular bronze hammer, kind of like the copper one. I used the same shape and everything, but it didn't specifically say in the book that I could do it that way. In other words, it's not saying like every last recipe. So it's kind of doing it a little too assumptional as far as I'm concerned. It's just throwing it out there. So it's like, yeah, you can kind of approximate. That is true. I can approximate. But at the same time, is that something that they should really assume everybody's going to do? I don't think so. It's just one of those things. I'm trying to find, really quickly, if I can, the instructions to make the rest of the structure. I have to, no? Okay. These are things that I don't think it's showing it right there. I don't think it'd be under commodities. Oh well. Well, I can look this up later. Mostly. Oh well. I'll figure this out later. Okay. So, this is a Glitch Reaper. Again, I'm still a Steve, but I'll be back with my regularly scheduled Minecraft skin at some point, hopefully. I will record offline and upload whenever I get opportunities to. So this is something that will happen once in a while. But never mind that for now. It's more on my end. Well, this is Glitch Reaper. I'll be signing off for now. So, hope to hear from y'all again. So, bye for now.